Hello friends, so having understood about the accounting concepts and conventions in the previous lecture, now we are going to proceed ahead to understand the next concept, and that is the concept of accounting equation. While discussing accounting concepts and conventions, we discussed about one of the very important and very fundamental accounting concepts, that is dual aspect concept, which was propounded by Sir Luca Di Pacioli. और क्या कहा था सर लुका डी पैसियोली ने वो कंसेप्ट में, तो उन्होंने कहा था कि जैसे हर प्लस का माइनस होता है, जैसे हर नॉर्थ पोल का साउथ पोल होता है, ठीक उसी तरह इन अकाउंटिंग एवरी डेबिट शुड हैव एन कॉरस्पॉन्डिंग एन इक्वल अमाउंट ऑफ क्रेडिट, एंड दैट इज एग्जैक्टली वेयर ही हैव गिवन अस दिस अकाउंटिंग इक्वेशन. नाउ इफ यू एनालाइज योर बैलेंस शीट, we will see what is balance sheet when we'll do financial statements, but balance sheet is a statement that contains the list of all the assets and liabilities, all the receivables and payables. To ek business mein businessman ko kitna lena hai aur kisko kitna dena hai, uski jo summary hoti hai usse kaha jata hai balance sheet. To agar aap ye balance sheet ko analyze karte hain, and if I represent the entire asset side with A, the capital with C and the liabilities with L, then you will notice that the accounting equation is what? Ideally, under double entry system or dual aspect concept, where every debit is having an equal amount of credit effect, the total of asset side should be equal to total of liabilities side. That means what? Can I say that capital plus liability should be equal to assets? Please recheck once. Capital plus liability should be equal to assets. Or can I make two more equations out of it, that capital is equal to assets minus liabilities, or lastly liabilities is equal to assets minus capitals. So hum kya karte hain ab is accounting equation ke concept ko aur better tarike se samajhne ke liye, let's take couple of examples. So let me tell you, let's suppose one, Mr. A purchased a car for rupees 5 lakhs. Mr. A purchased a car for rupees 5 lakh. He paid down payment of rupees 1 lakh by check, and balance by bank loan. So you got a transaction that Mr. A purchased a car for rupees 5 lakh, he paid down payment of rupees 1 lakh by check and balance by bank loan. So your accounting equation suppose is equal to asset is equal to capital plus liabilities. So how will this equation change as a result of this particular transaction? Wo ab humko yahan pe dekhna hai. So Mr. A has purchased a car. Car Mr. A ke liye, let's take an example, asset. Mr. A has purchased a car. Car kya hai? Asset hai. So can I say as a result of this transaction an asset is coming in the business of rupees 5 lakh? To main yahan keh sakta hu that my asset is increasing by rupees 5 lakh. Are you understanding? Now to buy this car, he is making payment from his own bank balance of rupees 1 lakh. Bank balance is an asset. Now I made payment out of my bank balance, that means can I say my asset decreased by rupees 1 lakh? And how I made payment of balance 4 lakh rupees? I've borrowed it from a bank, that means I've taken a loan. Loan is my liability, so can I say my liability increased by rupees 4 lakh? There's no change in capital, so I'll write as it is. Now if you see the net effect of this particular transaction, my assets increased by 4 lakh, capital is unchanged and liability also increased by 4 lakh. So left hand side is equal to right hand side. Let's take one more example. Mr. A purchased goods on credit for rupees 10,000 from Mr. B. Mr. A purchased goods for rupees 10,000 from Mr. B. Credit transaction hai. So again accounting equation हम लिखते हैं, asset is equal to capital plus liability. अब ये accounting equation कैसे change होगा? Mr. A purchased goods. Goods का मतलब होता है those goods which are purchased with the intention of resale. तो ये goods purchase किए हैं 10,000 के जो आगे बेचना है. Goods मतलब मेरा stock. Stock is my asset. So my asset increases by rupees 10,000. Now have I paid anything for it? If I would have paid cash, तो मेरी asset भी decrease होती थी. If I would have paid check, तो भी मेरी asset decrease होती थी. But मैंने यहाँ कुछ pay नहीं किया है. मतलब my liability, sundry creditor increased by 10,000. Now if you analyze the total impact of this on your accounting equation, you can say 10,000 is equal to 0 plus 10,000. So your asset side increased by 10,000 and liability side also increased by 10,000. Now I see Mr. A sold goods costing rupees 5,000 for rupees 7,000. The customer paid in cash entirely. So he have sold goods costing 5,000 for rupees 7,000. Matlab, can I say there is profit of 2,000? To ye transaction ka accounting equation kya hoga? Dekhte hain. Asset is equal to capital plus liabilities. Now, my dear friends, he have sold goods costing 5,000. 5,000 ke goods beche hain. Goods matlab meri inventory. Inventory matlab asset. My asset decreased by 5,000. ठीक है, कस्टमर को बेचे हैं, कस्टमर ने आपको 5,000 के गुड्स के बदले 7,000 की कैश दी है. कैश इज कमिंग इन द बिजनेस, कैश इज माय एसेट इंक्रीजेस बाय 7,000. सो आप देख रहे हैं यहां पे नेट इंपैक्ट क्या हुआ है एसेट पे, माय एसेट इज इंक्रीजिंग बाय 2,000. व्हाट इज द चेंज ऑन द अदर साइड? So, liability में कोई चेंज नहीं है, लेकिन ये जो 2000 का प्रॉफिट हुआ है ना, ये प्रॉफिट कहाँ ऐड होता है? दिस प्रॉफिट गोज एंड गेट्स एडेड टू माय कैपिटल. सो माय कैपिटल इंक्रीजेस बाय 2000 विदाउट एनी चेंज इन लाइबिलिटी. सो माय डियर फ्रेंड्स, कैपिटल इज इक्वल टू 2000 प्लस सी. सो अगेन यू कैन सी अकाउंटिंग इक्वेशन टैलीड ओवर हियर. So, my dear friends, accounting equation means what? It is nothing but dual aspect of the double entry system of accounting, where after every transaction, your total assets will equal be total liabilities plus total capital. Very, very important for us to understand. Now, my dear friends, I'll take one another example just for practice purpose. Let's say Mr. A paid telephone charges. Mr. A paid telephone charges rupees 1,000 by cash. In cash. Rupees 1,000 in cash. Now my accounting equation says asset is equal to capital plus liabilities. He paid telephone charges of 1,000 in cash. Cash is going out of the business. Cash is my asset. So my asset decreased by rupees 1,000. Now telephone charges is my what? Expenditure. This expenditure results into decrease in capital. So my capital also decreases by 1,000. So you can see your accounting equation is again tallied. So my dear friends, accounting equation is nothing but it is based on the principles of dual aspect concept, which says that for every debit, there has to be a corresponding and an equal amount of